Hey you fellas, it's me, Rika. I'm extremely angry right now because I just finished recording this whole thing, only to realize I had my microphone physically muted the entire time, rendering that entire thing completely pointless. Keyboard, haha. What game are we playing today, buddy? What? No, we're not doing Jailbreak again. I already, hold on, try again. No. Tell me the truth! Oh. Well, I guess that's fitting, because I'm really mad right now, and we're going to talk about Mad City, a game that's free mad. The city is mad. The Mad City. I'm mad. Mad City is a game developed by Swifty Studios. You could have picked any name for your studio, and that's what you picked. Swifty Studios is led by Taymaster, most well known for his just great track record of original games. His most popular, of course, being Murder Mystery. The Mad Murder. Excuse me. Twisted Murderer. So given that information, I didn't really have high hopes for this game, especially considering it's already been causing a bit of controversy on Twitter, with people like Beeism calling them out for just being a blatant ripoff of Jailbreak. And I can't blame them at all, because even not having played the game yet, my first impression is just, everything about this is just taken from other things. The name of the studio, the logo of the studio, the logo of the game, the concept of the game, nothing here is original, but we'll see, you know, I could be incorrectly judging. I'm sure this game has some cool twist to make it stand out. Probably not, but I can get my hopes up.
Quite frankly, I already have a really bad feeling about this, just from the studio logo looking exactly like the Supreme logo, but whatever, let's get started. As I explained earlier, the only real difference from Jailbreak in terms of the core concept here is the addition of heroes, and I have a lot to complain about there, but we'll get to that later. Let's start off as a prisoner. As you'd expect, you start off in your prison cell and wait a bit for the doors to open so you can begin your escape. I said the doors will open. What am I supposed to do? It should be open right now. Hello? Okay, time to reset. Are you gonna let me out this time? There we go. As I was saying, let's begin our escape. This works exactly as you'd expect, because there's only so many ways you could put a prison escape in your game, but there are a few differences from Jailbreak's version. For instance, you can search through things like boxes or trash bins for loot. You can find a lockpick to pick locks, a shovel to dig your way out, or various other materials that can be used in crafting. And on the subject of crafting, the way it works in this game is really weird. I spent a good amount of time searching for a menu to actually throw my materials into, but apparently the items just automatically craft themselves if you get the materials. I guess you could say it streamlines the process or something, but when I'm told there's crafting in a game, I'm obviously gonna look for a menu to do it, right? This game is already bloated with interfaces, so I don't see why that needs to be left out. Either way though, the result is the same. You escape prison and get out of there through a conveniently placed car. Let's go! Why is it not going? Okay, there we go. There's another thing I need to talk about. I'm sure this sounds extremely nitpicky, but I am not a fan of how it takes a couple seconds to start up the car, instead of just allowing you to jump in and go immediately. Hear me out, okay? Imagine you're being chased down by a cop right here, right now, and you gotta get in your car, but hold on, Buster, don't go yet!
We gotta wait, just wait, buddy!
This, among other little things, like the incredibly slow dialogue pop-ups, all makes the game as a whole feel far more clunky. Can you believe we just got out of prison and I've already done that much nitpicking? So let's continue into the city and go over the amazing criminal activities at our disposal. You can rob things like the bank and the jewelry store and various small stores where you can steal from the cash register. You guys really just want to give me perfect comparison material, huh? To be fair though, there are plenty of different robberies you aren't going to find in a certain other game, most notably the casino and even regular house break-ins. Even if all the others function identically to their older counterparts, the new additions like this at least sort of enhance the experience. It's enough to make me feel like I'm not playing the exact same game, though it's still pretty close. There's really not much to say about being a criminal outside of that, so let's move on to the police. There also isn't much to say about this role, because it is still what you would expect. You catch criminals, get paid for doing it, and inevitably get caught up in those bunny hopping matches where neither party is able to defeat the other for a good minute or two. We have a lot of cool weapons though, like this one. Oh right, it's a game pass, of course. Would have been nice if they picked that as one of the few things to not copy, but well. I also find it interesting how the weapons are laid out in such a way that it's pretty much guaranteed you'll accidentally open the game pass prompt, since it's safe to assume most people would just run across them and spam E so they can pick up their weapons quickly. Poor design choice or intentional nuisance? Who knows? I can only think of one mechanic that makes the cops in this game stand out compared to the other game, which would be the fact that killing someone will still get them arrested, rendering handcuffs obsolete. Some might say this is overpowered, but I say cops need any advantage they can get in this game, and you'll see why later. Finally, we'll move on to the main selling point of this game, the heroes. As a hero, you get your own secret base inside the volcano and have 5 different classes to choose from.
You got the red man who goes really fast, the orange man who shoots the big fire, Superman who flies and shoots laser, Raven who flies and shoots purple spheres, and the other orange guy who does electricity.
The superpowers available here are decent, albeit a little generic, and some classes are significantly more powerful than others, leaving me wondering why anyone would ever want to play someone like the electricity guy. All things considered, I think heroes were one of the most fun aspects of this game, and at least provided something worthwhile-ish. Now that we're done covering the specifics, I'd like to take this time to talk about some more general problems this game has. With the introduction of heroes as a second police force, this naturally comes with some balancing issues, but maybe not in the way you'd think. Somehow this game still has the issue of servers consisting mostly of criminals and nobody stopping them. The description even says, "With so many robberies, the chaos never stops." Yeah, I wonder why. It also doesn't help that heroes are specifically blocked from infiltrating a criminal base. Meanwhile, criminals are able to freely enter the hero base and spawn camp to their heart's content. I am genuinely concerned by what kind of thought process would have to go into such a decision. What is the fun in playing as a criminal when there is little to no threat at any given time? Seriously, oftentimes I would see another player flying around in the distance and get excited thinking it was a hero to fight, but nope, it's just a criminal who inherited the powers of a hero he killed. Because that's a thing you can do. Apparently criminals needed even more power? I sincerely apologize if I'm beginning to sound irrationally angry, but this just boggles my mind. How can one game that is completely derived from another game that was already perfectly fine have this many poor design choices? I'm stunned, quite frankly. A Roblox game hasn't gotten me so genuinely upset in a very long time. And one last complaint before I go. This game has pretty wonky physics. I found myself getting stuck in various places quite a few times, and sometimes jumping into the water from a great height will just fling you? I don't get it. There are some other miscellaneous things to check out here, like the pirate ship in the distance, helicopters, expensive vehicles, that sort of thing, but none of those would really change my opinion at all, so my work here is done. Adios.
So in conclusion, Mad City really does not do anything groundbreaking or interesting for the Roblox open world genre. I've seen people argue on Twitter that it's necessary to have imitators to evolve a genre. And while I can't agree with that, this doesn't do anything to evolve it. Like I just said, it is a carbon copy. That's all it is. Just with a bit more of a cartoony feel, I guess. I don't know if that's the right word for it. And I'm all for competition too. Of course, Jailbreak couldn't stay at the number one spot forever. But when I thought of a competitor to Jailbreak, I didn't think of a carbon copy. Okay, it might have been similar. It might have been open world. Heck, it could have even been a prison escape game too. But it didn't have to be a carbon copy like this. And who knows, maybe they'll add in some twist in a future update to make it really good, but unfortunately I kind of doubt that's going to happen. So Vorty, I guess I can thank you for at least showing me a game that's both trendy right now and interesting for me to talk about. Those two things don't really go hand in hand most of the time, but the game was still pretty lame, so goodbye. I don't like you anymore. I never liked you. And this game gets a funny hand gesture from me, you know, like the boy. Boy!